Hey, Mike here, michaelpitluck.com, and in this video, this is video number 8, I believe, of our building a sales page from scratch using Thrive Architect. And if you're interested in the Thrive Themes products, then check the description below the video for a link. It's an affiliate link, so I would definitely appreciate it if you bought a Thrive product through my link. All right. So what we're going to do is continue building the sales page here. This is a live build and it will be a live sales page. So this is what we have so far. We have the hero section for the course. We have the problem copy, the solution copy here, and we're going to get some images going through these sections. But we have a little story here about the background, why I created it, my musical background that kind of transitions into the course. And then we have some testimonials. We have some results. We have exactly what you get in the course, the meat of the course. And we made this little GIF last time, which was a lot of fun. And then here we have the bonuses. And this is what we really dove into last time, kind of trying to figure out how to dial this in. And that's what this video is going to be about, is dialing this section in, just getting it a little bit nicer. And then after the bonus section, what we need to do is then create a pricing table. Basically, are you ready to go? And here is what you get, the value stack, and then also the price, the join now. And the entire sales page is basically there to increase the perceived value of the product so that when the price is finally revealed, it seems like it's really, really low, like you're getting a lot of value. And, you know, of course, I think you are, and I'm pricing it in a way that I think is affordable, but brings a lot of value at the same time. But of course, we got to structure a page in a way that's going to make sense logically, emotionally, for when someone's going through it, so that when the price is revealed, it feels like the right move to make to purchase the course. And of course, I feel that way, but it takes a lot of design and psychology almost to make sure that to increase the likelihood that someone will make a purchase, because they will benefit if they make the purchase. And if they don't, of course, that's why you have guarantees. Pricing table and then the guarantee. And then, so let's dive in and start putting things in containers, because this is going to be kind of more of a designy video. So let's edit with Thrive Architect up here at the top of the page. And I did find kind of an inspiration, because I was having trouble in the last video looking at, this is interesting, this is kind of like what Proof does, but I don't know who is doing this one. Maybe HubSpot, I think, is what Hyperbits uses, or he uses, he uses Entreport. So I'm not sure who, div class, span, okay. Sumo form. Oh, interesting. Scroll out. I'm just looking to see who creates this. Okay, anyway. Similar to what Proof does, but, you know, you nerd out on this stuff and you try to figure out what's going on people's pages and what they're using. Maybe you should use it too, and waste a lot of time learning new software that you don't end up using. But, this was the inspiration that I had for the bonuses. See how they have the bonuses, the individual bonuses in containers? This was the thing I was having the most problem with, is how do I box that bonus? How do I make this title stand out? And so you can see what's going on here is inside the container, there's a little bit of gray behind this. But I like also that the value is added here. It's a lot of information. You have bonus number, you have the title of the bonus, and then you have the value. That's a lot of information to digest. But I can't imagine where else to put it other than the pricing table. The pricing table, of course, is going to have the value of everything listed. But I think it's important to put it beforehand as well. So what we'll do, especially because like I was just talking about how you want to increase the perceived value of the product so that when you reveal the price, it seems a lot lower than the perceived value that you built up. And so when you start dropping in like values here, like 247, 197, what's the most expensive one? 197, 247 is still the most expensive, 249. And so that way, when you get down here, you see 297. Well, here's two products that are, you know, 249 and two, what's the other one? 247. Like the value alone from these bonuses is worth more than what you're going to actually pay for the entire thing. Right. And so that's kind of what you're trying to set up. Because I mean, and it's not like you're lying about this stuff. So if, for example, when I'm posting these bonuses here and I'm going to put the value, if someone goes to my website, that's how much they cost. And so if they do purchase the suite version of this course, they are going to get these extra bonuses at a significant discount. So anyway, what we're going to do now is start putting things in containers. Okay, because that's a design thing, but this is a little bit involved because what I need to do is start messing around with content boxes. As you can see, this is all in one content box, but if I want to have the testimonials here inside their own content box, obviously the content box has to go outside of the has to go outside because I want the text all to have the same width, but that means that the content box needs to go outside the width of this content box here, of this container that I already have things in. So what that means is kind of a pain, and it's also kind of a pain when you switch to the mobile view because then I'm going to need to really fine-tune the spacing between these two content boxes, but we'll get there when we get there, all right? So let's go ahead and start I'm doing this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate the content box here, and I'm just going to start deleting all this stuff. See, I should have really already put some of this stuff into content boxes, right? That's why it's really convenient to throw these things into content boxes because you can just quickly do, it just makes things faster. So here we are. We are at our first content box for Zach's testimonial here. And what I need to do now is basically duplicate this content box and start deleting Benjamin's here, Ben's. And then there we go. Let's start deleting Zach. So everything is in their own content box. So here we go with Benjamin. And what we need to do is, we need to duplicate this and again, just delete everything except the enroll now button. There. Now, everything is still in the right container width. Everything still looks exactly the same, but everything is now separated into their own content boxes. Okay, so now what we need to do is here we have this content box. And I need to then put a content box inside this content box. I know this is getting ridiculous, but it is necessary. So I'm going to start putting all this stuff in here. And of course, what we need to do is get rid of all the crap around the content box. So this is going in here. So we're having a content box inside of a content box. Okay, cool. So if I go to this content box, you see it goes around, and now we need to start getting rid of margins. So we're going to play with that later. But so we have this content box that's just wrapped around Zach's testimonial here. And then we have another content box exactly the same, but this is the one that we need to change. Okay, so now what we need to do is increase the width. Okay, not quite yet. What we need to do is come to this content box and we need to have a width of 600 and we need to make sure it's centered. Okay. So now when we come to this content box, I can move it outwards and nothing's going to happen there. So maybe what we'll do is just move it out for now, 50 pixels each way. So we need to have 700. Okay. Eventually I'll get it right. There we go. 700. And then what we'll do is change the padding here. Stupid content boxes. Okay, so now, actually, yeah. Okay, yeah, see, if I do a padding here, then that's not what I want. Okay, so now we're going to start pushing this guy down. So we'll do it by 50. It's funny because this 50 looks more than this 50, even though they're both 50 pixels. So that's just a little trick. So you just kind of have to maybe eyeball it. Maybe we'll just do 40. Okay, so 40 up top, 40 below. Awesome. And then, of course, what we need to do now is the content box needs to be a different color. So we're going to go to background style. And this is going to be F2. Yeah, I think we've been using F2. And then, of course, we need to put a border around it just like this. And it's going to be the lighter border. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the nines. Bam, there we go. Just like that. Okay. So that's one testimonial. And that's exactly what we need to do for Ben here. So we'll come to, we need to create... Let's get rid of these margins because we will fix them in a moment. We need to put a content box in the content box. So let's start dragging everything in. Nope. What we need to do is get rid of all that crap. Get out of here. Okay, so now we need to go like this. Maybe there's a faster way to do this. There probably is, but maybe not in the way. But doing it this way satisfies my OCD. So we need to come to the content box here. So there's something going on. There we go. We need to get rid of this. Okay, is there a... Good. I got rid of the one above Zach's picture as well. So let's come to the content box. And what we need to do for this first one is have the fixed width there. Auto on the sides, and then what we need to do is increase this to 700, and we need to have, what was it, 40, and then tab 40. Bam. Okay, and then let's go ahead and save. And then of course we need to change the background to F2. All right, F2. Save. And then finally, we need to do the borders, and it's going to be the nines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Cool. There we go. Beautiful. Okay. Maybe the color's not the greatest. Maybe let's try the lighter gray. Let's try it. Okay. Let's go to Nope. We don't want the borders. We want to come to background. So... F9. Okay, here we go. Okay, that still stands out, doesn't it? Okay, maybe it's not as abrasive or ugly. So we'll go F9. Nice. Okay, so how much space do we need in between these guys? How much space? So that's 32 pixels. What's the border on this? On the margin, I mean. So... Okay, where is that padding coming from? Where is... So if we come to the content box... Okay, there it is. Okay. So it was 20 pixels. So it was really 50 because here we had the... we need to do 50. Okay, there's 50. And then from Zach, we need to go down 50. Here's a question. Should I put a shadow behind this? Make it a little bit more subtle. 20. I think it looks good. Is there an angle on this? I'm going to take the distance away. In the distance, you can see that the shadow is kind of creeping down a little bit. So if I take the distance away, it's just going to put the shadow around the entire box. And I like the way that looks. So we will come here and we'll add a shadow to Ben as well. And it will be more subtle. Let's go to 20% opacity. Plop. Nope. 20%. There we go. Apply. And then we'll bring the distance away as well. Apply. Save. All right. I like this look. All right. That's not bad. So that's what I was talking about with the containers. Right, Zach's in a container. Let's see. What's the distance here? What's this button doing? And I don't like the fact that the button's controlling the margin. So that's 50. What's this guy doing? And why is there still space? That's why. All right. So let's have the content, Ben's content box, control the margin. 50. They're a little close. Let me just jump over here really quick. So look how close these are too. I'm not sure if I'm really into that. You can see this shadow is doing something similar. It doesn't have the distance has been taken away. It's just glowing around the entire box rather than biasing one border, you could say, one side. But they're pretty close together. But the reason why this works really close together is because you have this yellow just as a clear delineation for each one. But I fear that... Look at this too, just that white with the yellow background, just clear delineation. Man, clarity and structure, wow. That's a lot of logos. Let's see, so if we come over to here, we don't have that clear delineation. Maybe we need to make the boxes, Maybe we need more space in between them. One of the things I love on this page, look at these colors down here. I think it was on it. Oh, yeah, look at this. Look at that gradient. It's awesome. And this whole section, that gradient, that's really cool. I'm not that fancy, though. Okay. Okay. I'm not sure what to do here. So what I'm going to do is move on. So if someone's scrolling... All right, it's all about taking that visitor perspective. Someone's kind of scrolling. Damn, it'd be really nice if we had just a clear way of... You know what? Maybe what we could do is this. This might be clever. For the top border... Well, no, we need this. Shoot. Okay, so for this top border, maybe what we could do is, what's this color? No, we want the pop color. Let's get this color. Let's get main options. Okay, we got about 10 minutes to go here. So... F9. Let's get this. Apply. And then, maybe we can come over to the borders. Let's try putting this color border around it. What does that do? Kind of stupid. All right, so let's go back to 9, 9, the 9s. But what I want to do is the top border, let's try making this that color, and then let's try increasing it. Ooh. Save. Okay, let's try this color. Or, oh, this is just gonna be impossible. Nah. Ooh. Ooh. Let's see. Let's go to background style. Let's copy this. Apply. And then let's do this. Maybe we can go one shade lower. So if we come over here and get this, let's get this color. And then we'll go like this. One tint lower, I guess. Oh, see, okay, this is what I was talking about with the this being a pain in the ass on mobile. So what we need to do is come to which content box? This content box here, and we need to put padding. So 15. Now, it's not going to actually make a difference to the desktop version, but when we jump over to the mobile version, watch this, see that? Now we're going to get that nice padding on the inside. What if we made this the next darker up? Just again, so there's more contrast between this orange and this orange, for example. What would happen? What if we got this one? Okay, so let's come over here and background style. Did that make... Oh, shit. Did that make any difference? Let's come over here and let's get this. Okay. Okay, let's look. It does make a difference. I like that color. Let's go with this color because there's going to be more contrast between these two. This is two shades lighter now, two tints lighter than this one. Stronger, right? Feels stronger. Boom. And then let's do the same thing with this. Here's exactly what you get. I like that stronger orange. All these orange tints. Cool. We've only just begun bonuses. Okay, cool. So, I think that works. What color is this? Okay, let's get this guy copy, apply. And then, let's come over here. What about that gray border? Is that not very good? What if we took away the border? And then let's give this one back. What the fuck is that? Why is that turning white? Background. Okay, yeah, we want this one. So border. That is really annoying. Copy, for crying out loud. Okay, and then border. Okay. So does that work? Does it work if there's no border? It just doesn't feel as contained. I mean, this one has a clear border just because it's not really a border on this one. The shadow is just a little bit darker. Let's check it out. Okay, what if we made the shadow a little bit darker? Let's go back to 40%. I don't like it. I want... Okay, and then what we'll do is go to borders, and we'll do 99. See, nice clean border. I like that. And then we'll go to the top. Let's go get this color again. Why is that turning? That's so annoying. And then we will come to borders, top border. Let's change the color here, and then let's increase it to 10 pixels. Okay, cool. And so with this one, same thing. Let's come here. Nope. Let's come to the top border, drop in the color, and then we'll increase 10. Okay. I was worried that with the darker orange, the black wouldn't show up as well, but it seems to really show up nicely. Even if I had this like fully, I don't know, it just works. Okay, and then we get the testimonials containers. Pretty good. It's not the worst thing in the world. Okay, let's see. Let's go here. I don't know. Just feel like a little more space between these is needed. Let's do 75, right? Because if we're using multiples of 25 and 100, then I think 75 is a nice little distance there. All right. Okay, cool. So, now we need to make containers for these guys. So I think these are just going to be white. So that's less of a pain. But the pain is that I have to then do all this over again. Oh, wait. Do I not need to? No, I need to. Damn. Okay, so let's duplicate this and start deleting. So connect back to the main promise. So this is what I need to put into the border. So we'll go ahead and start deleting this. Not into the border, into the container. Anthony, Jorge. Okay. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Yeah. All this needs to go. Okay. There we go. Okay. Now let's go ahead and duplicate this content box. But first, we have to get rid of all this. Jorge is an OG. He is an OG. And then let's get rid of this and this. Great. Oh, we got to get rid of this guy. Because now is Anthony's turn to shine here. Okay. Wait a minute. Okay, cool. And then we need to select the content box, duplicate this, and start getting rid of everything but Anthony, basically. So, Jorge, seal. Ah! So, get rid of all this. Anthony, you're out of here. Jorge's gone too. Wait a minute. Wait. No, we want Jorge. There we go. And let's get rid of some of these captions while we're here. Nope, no caption. DJ, okay, so Jorge, we want Jorge. So now what we'll do is duplicate this and just get rid of, duplicate the content box. And start getting rid of, okay, there we go. So it got faster as time went on. Okay, there we go, cool. Nice. Okay, cool, so now what we need to do is all that other stuff. So let's get a content box and drop it in here. Start moving this stuff in. Nope, come on. There we go. So title, image, blah, blah, blah. And then let's go to the content box and change all that around. Get rid of all this crap. And then we need it to be 600 pixels in the middle. This one is going to be 700. 700. And then we have 40 on top. We have 40 on the bottom. And the background for this content box is going to be white. Just like that. And then we're going to have a border like this. And it's going to be the nines. There we go. Okay, that's... maybe we can still do that orange top border, though. So I'm not sure if I still have the... Nice. Okay, so the top one, so what we can do is 10. There we go. Nice. That's not that bad. Not half bad. So let's finish the rest of them here. So let's move this in. This guy's moving in. This is moving in to... If you... Okay. There we go. And this... There we go. Great. Okay, let's get rid of all the crap. Layout, this, goodbye. Great. Content box, this needs to be 600 centered. And then the outer content box needs to be 700. I keep hitting 400. 700 with padding of 40 on top, tab, 40. Great. We need the background style to be white. We need a border around it. 9999999999. And then we need the top border, though, to be the lovely orange. And we need that to be 10 pixels, just like that. All right. And maybe what we could do is set this up to be 75 pixels, just like the ones above. So 75, just like that. And Anthony is going to also be pushing Jorge down 75 pixels. All right, Jorge's turn. So what we'll do is get the content box. This guy goes in here. This goes in here. Oh my gosh. This goes in there. This goes right here. Okay, content box. Get rid of all this. Get rid of this. We need this to be 600. This is going to be centered. content box, layout and position, 700, 40 padding, tab, 40. We need to get the background style to be white, and we need borders here, bam, different color, 9s, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we need the top border to, of course, be that lovely orange color, the pop color, 10, bam. Everyone's looking their best now. Okay, so now maybe we can also add the shadow. So we will do 20 opacity. Take the distance away. Goodbye. Okay, the shadow is done. Anthony, let's get your own shadow here. So shadow, there we go. Distance 0, opacity 20. I'm thinking in my head right now of parallel structure, because up here we have Zach and we have Ben, but down here we have three. And so I'm thinking maybe if we just had two, but that's going to be a later decision, right? Just little weird psychological things, but who knows if it's total crap. It could totally be crap. Okay, so everyone has their shadow. Oh, okay, great. Wonderful. Looking good. But it delineates, right? Differentiates, distinguishes, right? This just simple little orange line on top. It just, when you're scrolling down, it's just bam, new section, right? Like before, that wasn't the case. Like you could easily just skip over it, but that orange pop color just helps differentiate these, makes it stand out. So if someone sees that orange, they'll probably read this. And this is the tiny little compelling story that I want to sum up what's going on in here. I want to create this little tiny compelling story in here. And if someone sees that pop color, they'll probably process at least the, oh shit. They'll probably read the story, that little tiny story, right? Anthony signed his first track and super stoked, right? That's exactly what's going on in here. He signed his first track and look at all the exclamation marks and all this stuff. It's awesome. All right. And then Jorge got top DJ support. All right. Awesome. And so maybe I don't need, I kind of like it. Again, it's one of those things that just divides these sections up a little bit. Maybe we can give a little bit more space though. What's the spacing here? It should be 75, right? Okay. Let's do 30. The heck? Why is that happening? Okay. Where's that space coming from? See this? The space right above that text? Where's that? Ooh, I know where it's coming from. It's coming from the content box. Bam. Okay, cool. So let's jump back over to 50 here. 40. 30. Yeah, because remember, this should be 32, right? So if we come, oh, but we got rid of it. Okay, whatever. That's fine. All right. Good, almost there. Oh, man, how far are we over on this one? Okay, only about 10 minutes so far. Okay, so let's get these guys into their own little sections. And, I know exactly what's going to happen. Yes. Where's that lighter color? When we're using this color. This is the color that we want. So let's go to background style. And I'm going to copy this color here. Let's put it on a notepad. Okay. Great. Okay, cool. So this is going to be really similar to... We need to do everything here from scratch again. So I'm not going to put this in another video. This all needs to belong in the same video. So we're going to keep trolling along here. So we need to get rid of everything but the start to finish pause. Oh, nice. Wait a minute. Okay. So we need to undo that. There. Okay, so we need to come to... What's going on? Content box. The full content box here. This is what we need. And we need to duplicate this. Great. And then we'll start deleting everything that's not the pause, the Solardo course. So these images are in a column. We need to delete the columns here. Text. Got to delete the styled list. Sequence of the groove. See you later. Text, come on. Kick drum mastery, image, text, this thing. What just happened? I feel like I just deleted a content box. Okay, no, just the image. Text, great. Now we need to delete this. Get out of here. Content box. This content box, another content box. Okay, so now we have bonus two. And so let's go to this content box and duplicate this. And so what we need to delete is everything but the templates. So bonus, image, text, headline, image, text, headline, columns. Ugh. Okay, great. Stylized list. Great. And then here we have bonus three. Okay, let's go ahead and duplicate this. Get rid of everything below the secrets of the groove here. I feel it. We're almost close. Secrets of the groove. Yeah, we want to get rid of everything below secrets of the groove. Okay, so now we're on kick drum mastery. Let's go ahead and duplicate this content box. Start getting rid of bonus number five. Great. And bonus number four. Get rid of that. And bonus number five. Great. Everything is now in their own lovely content box. Okay, so next thing we need to do is start putting them in new content boxes. So, bam, the title, the image, the text, and in this case, the toggle. Okay, we can get rid of that. Oh, I know what just happened because I put this with this together in a content box. I see. So maybe we can redo that. Okay, so what we could do is select the content box with both of these because that makes it a little bit easier. Image content box. Okay. Great. And then we'll... put this guy in here. Nope. What happened is that we moved that into a content box. Okay. This is so annoying. Okay, so that's inside of we have millions of content boxes now. Okay, so let's just move this in here. Below text. Okay. Jesus Christ. So many content boxes. Okay, so we have this content box. What's this? Why is this one not in there? Content box. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 4 content boxes here. Okay, we need to get rid of these. So what we're going to do is... we only need these two, right? So we'll take this one. How is this going to work? Okay, let's see. So let's take this one and this one. Okay, so there should be this empty content box here. Okay, so we just got rid of one. 1, 2. So let's get rid of another one if we can. Nice, there we go. Okay, great. And let's get rid of this. Sweet. So, for this one needs to be 600. Need to put it in the middle. And then we have this one, which needs to be 700. And in the middle. All right, and we'll get rid of the borders here. Great. Nice. Okay, finally, what we need to do is come over to this content box. We need to do the background white. Awesome. And another thing we need to do. Oh, this is just brutal. Content box. We need to duplicate this content box. Nope. We need to duplicate the content box. We need to delete everything but the title. Cool. So now this is in its own content box. But it needs to be... So let's go to layout, let's delete the margins and stuff. And so we're going to change this to 100%. So we need to get rid of this crap. And we'll move it back to the center. Okay. So this content box is going to be background style copy, just like that. Beautiful. And we'll do a little, and then we'll do the content box like this, and then we'll do borders just like before. Save. So why does that have to be the case? Is that actually going to screw it up? Jesus. That doesn't make any sense. Maybe if I change I don't know. There's some weird thing. I have no idea if this is going to work. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I have no idea when it comes to that stuff. But I thought maybe I could move this content box behind the other one. Oh, that sucks. Jesus. Just when you think you might have got it. Let's see. Let's go to preview. Yep, look at that crap. That sucks. That's insane. Of course, what I could do is just put borders on this, right? So like this, and then that might not be that bad. Okay, let's go to the content box, and then let's go here, and let's see if we go to the top one, we want that pop color, right? So let's come here. Main options, this color. And let's go to the outside content box. Let's see if we can get the top border here. 10. Okay, so I guess the way that it works is it's just that obviously there's a hierarchy in the HTML or the CSS or something like that. And so I'm not able to get this, the properties of this content box to show through. That makes sense. Okay, so what I need to do is just put it on the outermost thing, which is this content box around the text. So if we come over here and go like this, and then, So if we do 10, and then of course what we need to do is come to the padding and add 10, just like that. You gotta be shitting me. Okay, so where's this borderline coming from? This is borderline crazy. Oh my God, we have... Okay, I think we need to get rid of this. Oh my gosh, this is just getting worse and worse. Content box. So we want none here. Maybe we can have the gray one on the bottom. Okay, here's a thought. I'm already anticipating some problems in the future. That's why I'm jumping ahead a little bit. So, Okay. Let's put a little bit of the content box here. Go 15 and 5. No, a little bit more. Content box. Let's go 20 and 10. Okay. And then maybe we will put a border on the bottom of this content box. Okay. What if we take away that border? And then we have to adjust the okay. We just have to adjust the spacing inside here. So let's jump this to 10. All right. So 100, what we need to do is let's jump over here and do 75, 50, 75, 100, 75. Okay, and we can maybe introduce a little bit of space here. Let's go to this content box. 20. Okay. Can't even tell that it was italic or whatever. So let's go. What? All right, let's get rid of this border. And then with the text, we'll drop this down 30, probably. Just like the one above. Wait, is this 30? That is 30. Why does this one again seem more? Is it just the text thing again? Okay, so fine. Whatever.
Oh, let's go to 20.
40. Too much. Okay, nice. One done. What's this 10 and 10? Oh, okay, that's that. So, awesome. All right, sweet. So let's put the shadow on this. So 20. Apply distance 0. Apply. Great. Wow. That was a pain in the ass. Okay. Let's do it all over again a lot of times. Okay, this goes in here. These columns go in here. Text below columns, make sure. And the styled list, which we reformatted based on an earlier styled list. Good, this one seems pretty straightforward. So let's go to layout and position and get rid of all that crap. Okay, so 600. And down the middle. Okay, and I think we're working with 40 on the padding here. Okay, and then on the, not that column, this content box, this is going to be 700. And we want to have a white background. Okay. And let's come over to this content box. And we will drop this 75, like up above. Great. Okay, next we need to do the whole crazy thing here. Okay, so delete everything but the... Okay. Let's get the styled list out of here. So this bonus template here has a negative margin, and that was before... Thrive Themes had the ability to change the line spacing here, so I keep on having to fix that. But I'm super glad they introduced this line spacing. That is amazing. Okay, so what's all this? Why is there so much space? Oh, the 40. Okay, there's still space. Column. Jeez, I must have made this a long time ago because everything that was just right there made no sense. Why would I have the 20 margin on these images instead of the columns? Makes no sense. Okay, that makes way more sense. Okay, great. Wow. Okay. So what's this crap? Okay. So let's check this. So list item. Okay, that works. Ah, that 20. That 20 showed up again. But it should, because that's what we're... I'm sure we can actually change that manually on that specific list item, but I'm not going to do that. What we're going to do instead is change this to 20. Great. Okay, so this guy needs to be centered. All right. Yes. And then we need to get this content box, and we're going to change it to 100% wide, 100. What if we exit? Auto. There you go. What's going on with this? Oh, the 40. Oh, okay. 40. All right, shoot. Let's see. So what is going on with this? So we have 10, 10, and then 40. So we'll... Nope, we're in the text. Okay, let's get rid of that one pixel padding there. So content box, we have 10, dash, dash, 10, and then we have 40. Okay, and then, so that is the content box. And then what we need is the color. So let's grab the color. And so we need the background style. Let's grab this. Get this content box, background style. Okay, and then borders, yes, 999. Great. Another one. And then same with this. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is that right? Beautiful. what's going on with these? So 40, and then what's this going? So 30. Okay, so let's get these columns and we'll push this down 30. There we go. Okay, is that it? Wow, okay. That was a lot faster. So we'll do shadow, and this is going to be 20% opacity and zero distance. Save. Ow, bitch. Jesus. Why does this seem bigger? Maybe because the font's bigger. 32. What's this? 32. What the heck is going on? Text. Okay, so what we're going to do is just copy this one over. I have no idea what's going on with that. Right? Look at that. What the heck? Makes no sense. Okay, save. Awesome. Okay, great. Now let's do it all over again. A couple more times here. So let's bring this in. I'm going to bring this in. This. Okay. Wait a minute. Ooh. I think I just got a little bit smarter. Oh, yeah. Watch this. So we put this in its own content box. This is in the big content box. So instead of doing all that crap, and we need to fix this. Jeez, I did make this page a long time ago. So we'll move and get rid of this. But if I then, maybe this is just a different text element. The code is different because it's an older element. Anyway, so if I take the content box here and duplicate it, I can get rid of the text, and then I can start dragging this stuff in. Look at that. Look at me. Look at that. Wow, well, that took way less time. So, but what we want is actually to duplicate this text. Oh my gosh, this is crazy. Watch this. So if I take this and duplicate this. Wow, look at me go. So Ableton templates, bonus number, what the fuck? Ah. Okay, I'm not sure what's going on. There we go. So let's take this, let's get the content box, duplicate the content box. Okay. And let's bring this one down into here. Okay. So, content box, good. Content box, perfect. So, let's change the text here to bonus number 3, secrets of the groove. Great. Let's get rid of this guy. Get out of here. And we can get rid of that content box. Let's make sure this one is in. So this one is in 1, 2. Great. So this content box needs to lay out and position. Okay. Okay, great. Yeah, because I copied that over already. So this one, we need to get rid of all this. Okay. And then, really? There's that much space? Maybe there's, yeah, margin on the picture. And then I think there's 30 margin that we need there. So next is coming to this outer one. So we need 700. 700. And then the inside one, we need to be 600. And there we go. So then the outside, we also need to change the background style to white. Cool. And then layout and position, we need to drop this 75, just like that. This one, we need the border, like that. 9. Okay. Ooh, but look at all this. We can't have shadows on shadows. That's just stupid. So we're going to get rid of the shadows in here. Like that. Nice. Good. No shadow on there. No shadow. No shadow. Just shadow. What the? No shadow. Bye. Okay, great. Clean. Okay, content box. Content box. We need to put a shadow around this. Again, we're going to drop it to 20% opacity, apply, and zero distance, apply, save. Okay, and then, so what is the 30, oh, this needs to be smaller text, 20. Okay, this also needs to be smaller text, 20. This also needs to be smaller text, 20. What is this? 20, 20, 20, 20, good. 20, good. Okay, so now what is the spacing? So 32. So the line spacing does change based on the font size. That's what I suspected in a way earlier video. So this is 32 pixels here, and we've been doing what, 40 on the inside? 20. Okay. What about this? Content box. Content box. So we want the second one, apparently. I think that's stupid. We need to... What the heck? Wow. I can't believe I missed this. So let's go to the outside content box and put some padding in here. So that's going to be 40. There we go. Jesus. And we need to get rid of one of these ridiculous things. Save. Okay. Fantastic. Okay, so that's 40 right there. What's this? Is this 40? 40, yeah. So what we'll do instead is put the use padding. Okay, or not. Okay, let's go to this one, and 40. Content box, let's do 40. Okay, it's going to be a... you know what? Okay, that's going to confuse me. So I'm not going to do 40 on that one. I'm going to do the 40 on the one that makes sense, which is the outside content box. That still makes sense. So let's do content box. Okay, so down at the bottom, that's not what we want. And also, is there any crap on this? Good. Why is there... What's this? Why is there so much space? List item? Oh, that's why. Can I take this away? No. Okay. I can't take it away. So stylized list, content box. We want the outside content box, so we're going to do an inside margin, inside padding. Obviously, it's an inside padding. Okay, so what we want is the second content box. I see. Okay, so again with this, we're pushing it down with margin. Let's use padding instead. So I'm going to use just like that. Okay. Just cleaner to me. Makes sense on where everything is. Right? Because like this gap right here, it doesn't make sense to think of it as this box pushing this gap down. It makes sense to think that there's just some padding in this box, right? And so that's why I'm kind of being anal about this, because you need to do what it needs to make sense. So we're going to come to this content box and do the padding 40. And then what else is going on? So this is what's the line height? 32. So we need to come to the outside content box and do 10. Just like that. All right. So because then that's going to be 42, which is fine. Close enough. Great. There's something kind of unattractive about this. I'm not sure what it is. Maybe if I just take some words away. Module 1, drums, 1 hour. There you go. Look at how clean that is, right? Module 2, bass, super clean. 1 hour. Look at that, right? I didn't need all that extra crap. Way better. That looks stupid. Does two module need to be hyphenated? I think it does. I'm not going to hyphenate it, though. Cool. All right. Almost there. This was a huge, major pain in the butt video. Okay. So, we're not going to do this. We're going to copy these guys again. Copy. Nice. Look at that. Yeah, there's no weird spacing crap. Okay, great. So, let's get rid of this. We need to copy this and put it in here. Just like that. And we need to get rid of this stupid hyphen. Kick drum mastery. And we'll come over to the background. Nope, not the background section. And we'll drop this down 75. Okay. So, content box, content box, content image. So we need to put all this into a content box. Content box. This is a content box. Okay, great. That's simple enough, I think. And so let's get rid of all the stuff. What, is there any stuff going on with the image? And we'll push the text down by 30. Okay, so there's obviously some weird... Oh, there's some text right here that we can get rid of. Nice. Perfect. Okay, cool. So we need to come to this content box. 600, right? 600, center, and we need to have a 40 margin padding right there. Okay. All right. And then we need to come to the outer content box because that needs to be 700. And we need it to have a white background. Background style, white. Yay. And then we also need it to have a border with all the nines. And we need it to have a shadow. It's getting faster and faster. That's what happens, I guess, when you do something over and over. Think of these little efficiencies. Awesome. Okay, now we need to figure out what's going on in here. Make sure that the text is the right size. We need it to be 20. This should be 32 now. So if I... Yeah, see? Now it's 32. Okay. Well, you'll learn. Okay. So this is 32. So again, what we need to do is come to the outside content box and push it by 10 on the margin and by 75 on the... Oh, I'm sorry. 10 on the padding, 75 on the bottom margin there. Save. Look at that. Super quick. Of course, we haven't looked at this in mobile, but I'm not even going to think about that right now. That's just going to give me a headache. Okay, so, and I don't think that these are poppy enough, these colors, right? So we're going to try using this color. Background. This. Copy. Apply. This. I don't know. We'll see. Kick drum mastery. All right. Final flipping bonus. Okay. Let's duplicate this. And I really hope that we can fit all. I think we can. If I just change the name a little bit, I think we can fit it in. So let's... Let's do that. Copy, paste, copy, paste. So we'll change this to deconstructions and breakdowns. Okay. So then what we need to do is come to the content box. Content box here, and we'll push this out to 700. Okay. Nope. Okay, so let's come to layout. 700. Nice, look at that. Oh, it fits. Yes. Okay, so 700, even though I'm willing to just have it go outside. I don't care. Whatever. Right, go outside the 600 text margin that we've set for this whole freaking sales page. I don't care. So what we need to do is come to the inside content. Oh, we haven't put this in a content box yet. So in here, this lovely image is going in here. This text is going in here. Let's quickly change the text to 20. And there's some default padding going on here, which I don't want. All right, great. And so here we should have 40. Oh, nope. One thing is we need to get rid of the margin here. 30, I believe, below the picture. In the content box here, we need to go. We need to get rid of all this. Zero it all out. 600. 600 in the middle. And we need to have 40 padding on top. We're going to have 40 padding there. Why not have 40 here? Whatever. 30. Okay. So, let's come over to this. I think that's it. I think we just need to get white there, and we need to do the borders and change the color. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Save. And I think just the shadow. Oh, that's an inner shadow. That looks disgusting. Distance 0. Oh, just working backward. Okay, 20. Save. Apply. Save. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. This is real. Okay. I was going to say, this is, seems really high. Whatever. Introducing the course, testimonials, results. That's super crisp and clear, in my opinion. Here's what you get. It's kind of scary that it moved. Okay. Okay, you get the full syllabus and breakdown. Expand to learn more. Let's do expand each module, right? You got to be explicitly clear. Explicitly clear? Is that a word? Does that make sense? You'll learn this stuff. Enroll now.
Bonuses.
Oh, shit. Okay, you know what, though? So this is 32. Let's see what other font sizes we can use. Hey, Siri, what is... shit. What's 20 times 1.618? That's got to be 30-something.
That would be 32.
You gotta be shitting me. Hey, what's 64 divided by 3?
The answer is about 21.3333.
Alright, fuck it. So what we need to do is just make these fit. So I'm gonna get all fancy with the... 97. Get all fancy with value. Trying to get all the fonts in the same size and stuff, but we just need to make sure this shit fits. And maybe what I could do is just color this a different color. Okay, and then what is this, 26, is that what the font is? So 26, and Kick Drum Mastery is a $29 value, of course, $29 value. Okay. And that is going to be the lovely gray color. Okay. Secrets of the Groove. $47 value. And this is going to be another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the text size is 26. The hold text size is 26. All right. And just to point this out, I started with this one first because this one needs to fit, right? That was the one that has the biggest clunky name. So now everything else is going to follow in their footsteps. So bonus templates here. This is going to be a $58 value because each template is $29 each. $58 value. Okay, so this needs to be the lovely gray 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we will 26 it. Save. All right, and then we have this guy, and this is going to be it needs to be 26 as well. Look at that. Is that too much space now with the smaller text? So we have $47 value, $58 value, $47 value, $329 value, $97 value. Okay. And let me check this sales page because I feel like maybe I didn't. You know what? If I go to a different... So we need to come to pages. Page. So what came first? New Year's sale or what was the other one? Black Friday. Let's find Black Friday. Package deal. Production system. Let's do I think it's the package deal. Let's check it out. Template model. Bonuses. I did that even for Secrets of the Groove. Okay. See how, like, even back, this was a couple months ago. I'm looking at this now. It's like, dude, what do I think this line right here is doing? You know, what's going to draw more attention? This toggle, this, or this line? You know, like, this line's not doing anything. And so it's not creating any kind of delineation. The pictures, if anything, are doing that. But you don't want the pictures. Maybe, you know what? The pictures would work better as a delineator if I put the title of the course underneath the picture. Because the first thing you see is the picture. And then you have to look up at the title. And then you have to look down at the content. That doesn't make any sense, right? I need something that catches the attention. Bam, you first see the title. Then you see the image. Then you see the other stuff. All right. So look inside. So what we're going to do here is I'm going to edit, and I like some of this copy. We're going to test look at this copy versus some of the other copy we have on the other page we were working with. So let's head on down to the bonuses. Oh, wow. This is a great FAQ section. Let's save this. FAQ. One million. See, I have no way of actually categorizing these yet. Plus, it would be nice if I could see what other modules I have saved so that I can actually give them proper names. But I have to just kind of come up with these ridiculous names. So kick drum. Okay, cool. So, yes. Okay, so let's go ahead and save this. So kick drum mastery. And let's see. Let's call this Black Friday copy. Okay, I'm going to copy Black Friday copy. So save as new template. Okay, same with this. So we'll do the content box here. And we will save. And so this is deconstructions. Deconstructions, Black Friday copy. Okay. And notice again, everything is in a content box. And that's what makes this so easy to save. So I could just hit save. And this is going to be SOG, Secrets of the Groove, Black Friday copy. So save that. So this isn't bad. You know, this green is kind of a goofy green. I would have preferred maybe to
use the green that Google likes. This is
horrendous. That's not gross. That just looks gross. I understand why I did it, though, at the time. At the time, I didn't want to mess around with colors, and it was just needed to be done fast. And so the most neutral thing for me at the time to do was just to use... was to use the gray. It's probably 999. So this was something I wanted to do maybe for this course too. Okay, let's see. Let's exit out of this search query and let's organize by date. Oh, okay. It looks like I need to upgrade here. Okay, come on. I don't need this. Come on. And then we'll go to, it's organized by date. So we'll edit. So we'll start messing around with the, one thing I guess we can, you know what? Let's go back. Let's go back to Black Friday. Because maybe what I can do instead of bringing in all the, screwing up everything we just did, I can just read the copy, because the only thing I really want to change is to bring in, I just don't like the way this looks. And so I think if I bring in the toggle, then it would be better. So I'm going to just select this one. So it's going to bring in the whole thing, right? But I don't need the whole thing. So instead, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select this toggle and bring it down. We'll just below text, right? Okay. Track deconstructions. You know what? I should add how long they are too. So what I need to do though is I can just delete now the content box. Again, it's so convenient to actually work with content boxes, even though I was kind of making fun of them before. So track deconstructions, look at that. There's another one that I just added, You Little Beauty. Okay, and how long is that one? Do I have any sales pages that have that on it? Yes, I think I do. I think, let's see, if we go to Zermelo, if we go to courses, and then we come here. I think I put it over here. Yes, 139.05. So 139.05. You Little Beauty. Oh, wow, this is just ridiculous. Hot pausa, right? Fisher. So let's do this too, because the whole thing is out of whack. Plus, I don't need to have the exact time, right? So let's just do 2 hours. 2 hours, right? 2 hours. Way easier to read, right? 2 hours. 1 hour. 3 hours. And 2 hours. Okay, so total, we have how many hours? So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 hours. 10 hours of track deconstructions. And then artist breakdowns, 1 hour, right? Let's just say, I don't know, 30 minutes, 30 minutes. 30 men, 30 men, okay? And so this is going to be 1 hour. Great. Okay. Oh, what we need to do is come to the content box here. What is this? Let's come to the toggle. And the toggle's... Okay, someone's causing some trouble. Okay, this I think is the toggle. Yes, it is. Let's get rid of all this crap. Okay, and then we'll come to the outer content box, give it an inside padding. There we go. Okay, cool. So that's that. So the next thing is I just want to know which copy I like better. So let's do a split screen here using Moom. And, yeah, let's come on over here, jump on down to the bonus section, and let's just compare the copy, okay? So, let's see. So, this says access, same thing, good. Okay, Secrets of the Groove. Secrets of the Groove is a crash course on drums and bass. Without question, the most important, you'll learn how to get, sure, that sounds... Sounds delicious. Okay. And I'm just infectious drum groove. And what we could do is another italics or something like that. Only tool to get your drums out. And so this one already has like two caps, so I can skip over that one. Drum bus compression. Fat drum sound. Okay, the three P's of bass sound design. That's the important thing right there. And we can italics for catchy bass melodies. For catchy, how to program. Okay, whatever. Maybe those aren't out as mouthwatering as the drum module, but whatever. Full bass sound. Full bass sound. EQing bass. Okay, so... Okay, what else is there? Kick drum mastery. Let's see what we have to say about kick drum mastery. Kick drum mastery. This 1 hour training saves you, gives you a unique perspective on kicks that I call dynamic splitting. The techniques of dynamic splitting are extremely powerful. You'll never have a kick and make or break your track. A kick and make or break your track. In 1 hour. This training is based on... called dynamic splitting. I hate when you have to have the quote go outside of a period. This training is based on a technique called, this training is based on a... Kicks again. My secret parallel transient. How to build your own kicks with zero technical issues. Whatever. Okay. I'm trying to sneak in dynamic splitting in there because it's a curiosity element, right? But I my brain's too slow. 7 a.m. now. I've been working on this since, I think, 10 p.m., so almost 9 hours straight. Okay, so I think that's it. Those are the bonuses I wanted to. I really just wanted to compare the copy. And it would be cool if I could sneak dynamic splitting here with the kick drum thing, because it is a curiosity element. But I really just wanted to break these guys down here with the track deconstructions, because people will definitely click on those guys. Access over 5 hours. Are you kidding me? 11. 11 plus hours of track deconstructions and artist breakdowns. Watch as I uncover the secret tricks of your favorite producers. Okay, cool. So I think it's going to wrap it up for tonight. I really wanted to finish this all in one go, but looks like, nah, I'm not going to be able to. Okay. Cool. All right. So we'll go ahead and save and preview. That's a wrap for this section. The whole thing we were trying to do was just get those containers going. And we made a couple other tweaks along the way, but I think the containers we made are pretty cool. Ah, that is so cool. Probably increase the padding there a little bit. Probably just by the exact same amount. My 10 pixels. Right, look at that. That orange just makes you look right at the title in the next line. Right, enroll now. Here's what you get. Start to finish pause style. You get a look inside the course, full syllabus, bullets. We've only just begun. Oh, nice. And then we're going into the bonuses here. These do help it stand out a little bit. But I think it... I think if we used a stronger color, it would be better. The only problem is I just feel like it would be awkward if we use a stronger color here. I don't know. I think it's okay. I think it's fine. Okay, cool. And so the next thing we're going to get into is the pricing table, finally, right? That section is going to start out with, are you ready to go, basically? And then the pricing table is just going to have everything that we've talked about here, start to finish, pause the styles, and all the bonuses, all the value, and then basically the price down at the bottom. And then we'll have the three tiers, and that's pretty much it for the pricing table. That's going to be pretty straightforward because Thrive actually has their own pricing table. And then after that, it's just going to be the guarantee, which should be super quick. Maybe some more testimonials, some FAQ, and then we'll have just another buy now button or enroll now, which just shoots you right to the pricing table. All right. It's been a long time since I went this in depth on building one of these. I'm literally building this from scratch. So, pretty cool. But, all right, that's it. Again, we're building this up from scratch using Thrive Architect. If you're interested in the Thrive Themes products, I do have a link below in the video description. It's an affiliate link. So if you are interested in the Thrive products, I would appreciate it if you did go through my affiliate link. I will get a small commission if you decide to go ahead and purchase a Thrive Themes product, but the cost will be the same for you one way or the other. Thanks for watching this video. I will see you in the next one, but I am going to go to sleep. But I don't think we have that much more to go anyway. All right. Again, thanks for watching. See you later.